As someone who has not played anything besides Apex Legends and Call of Duty Warzone in terms of Battle Royale games, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodhunt is yet another game in the bucket of games I won't ever play for myself. That doesn't deny the fact that there are tons and tons of people waiting for every single one of these to see what's the latest in the Battle Royale genre. And that's exactly the reason this video exists. This video is for everyone looking to improve the FPS numbers so that these split-second mouse movements are more accurate. Let's get to it. This is not a typical benchmark video that will show you what it's like to play the game on certain hardware. This is a video that will show you what it's like to improve the performance of the game on certain hardware. Before we proceed with the optimization process, you will need to download and install the Low Specs Experience. The download link can be found in the description of this video. Low Specs Experience is a game optimization tool that I developed that will allow you to optimize your favorite games for maximum performance. So, first of all, start the installation process for the Low Specs Experience. Once it's done, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut and select the optimization catalog. From the top menu, select the applicable digital platform and then select Vampire the Masquerade Bloodhunt from the drop-down menu. Once you are done, press load the optimization package. Low Specs Experience will now automatically check if the game version currently installed is supported by this optimization. If it is, press OK and the optimization control panel will load. When the optimization control panel loads, simply select the optimization presets and the resolution you would like to render your game at. This is something you will need to experiment on your own in order to see what works for your system the best. Once you decide which optimization presets and resolution you are going to use, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. Also, if you are not satisfied with what you see, you can always restore your game to default settings by choosing the Restore Default option. That's all from me for now. If you like what I do, please be sure to like the video and subscribe for more similar content. Anyway, I will see you all next time.